Ollie Hampson here, joined by Mark Cuddihy, the Cardiff Fire head coach. Good game tonight, big win against Wightlink again.
Yeah.
Got off to a great start, going in the first period, first minute as well.
Yeah.
How much of a factor did that play into the rest of the game?
It had a positive, but also a negative factor in the rest of the first period, because we got the first goal after 9 seconds, and then our second line went out there and scored again, and I think we took our foot off the gas for about 5 minutes. Let them back in with a goal, and suddenly realised, oh look, if we play like this, we're in a game. We picked up the intensity a little bit then, and I think Tax was fantastic in the first period, because I think we could have ended up coming in 3-2 down, to be honest with you. So yeah, I think it kind of had a little bit of a negative impact, but obviously it's great to get 2 goals straight away.
You mentioned the Tax there, you've had 3 goaltenders now this season, James White, Luke Tackle, Joey Myers. How much, like you've had this incredible win streak going on now, undefeated in the season. How much did it start in the back end? How much did it start with the goaltenders to have this winning season so far?
It's huge. Like James is, he's a starting goalie in this league. He's good enough to play as a starter in any other team in this league. And it's good to get him involved. It was good to give him the cup game the other week, and he was fantastic in that. We want to give him a few more games as well, and it's good then we can give guys a night off, so Joe Myers didn't play this weekend. So it's huge, and our two goalies, they should be in the league above, and they've been in the league above, and the league above that, and even the league above that, so they are a huge help to us, you know, because when you're 2-1 like that, and Tax saves 2 breakaways, that's a 3-2 game, and all of a sudden guys start getting nervous and we start missing passes, and anything can happen then, but it just settles everything down. A big save like that, when really they should score, it's huge for us, massive.
So when it comes to the shot department, I've noticed every single game I've been to now, you've heavily outscored, heavily outshot the other teams.
Yeah.
So, as well as outshooting the opponent tonight, you were definitely dominating them all over the scoreboard, as well as physically. Is that something you're trying to impose on the team, to be a bit more physical?
Yeah, it is. I mean, Wightlink had a few boys who could throw hits around. You know, Corey Watkins, again, he's very intense. You know, he pressures the D, and if you're slow to the puck, he's going to nail you. And, you know, we knew that we had to be on it and be aware of that and start throwing hits around ourselves. I think it's something that comes naturally to those boys. They like that style of hockey. I think it is a Cardiff style of hockey. It has been in all of my ENL teams over the last 10 years, and I think we always tend to come out and play physical and throw some hits around. It is just Cardiff hockey.
So I know you've got some of the smaller guys, such like Tam Elias, Jackson Prince, and Sam Bryant getting involved physically as well. Is it good to see some of the smaller, like not the size of like Russell Wilkinson, who got the match tonight, but some of those guys getting involved physically as well?
Oh yeah, definitely. And I mean, you look at Sammy Bryant, he's had 2 fights for us this year, and he's won them both. He's exceptionally physical player. Jackson the same, you know, Jackson gets stuck in, he gets involved in the corners, he throws the body around. Tamás is one of the most tenacious players we've ever had. The way he just digs the puck out behind the net, and he's so smart the way he does it, creates so many opportunities for us. And I think, you know, you mentioned Ross, you got big guys like that behind you, then the other guys can go around and throw the body around, and they can hit who they want and do what they want, because you know, you've got Manny and Wilco and some of the other boys that are ready to also step in.
So you mentioned Jackson there. From a coach's point of view, he's just come back from Kazakhstan playing in the university games. From a coach's perspective, how proud are you for getting onto that GB team?
Super proud, yeah, really, really proud. He's worked really hard. He's coming from Swindon. he's coming to us, and he's played on that fourth line, and that fourth line has won us at least 4 games this season. Just their speed, their tenacity, and their finishing has been immense. And you know, having Jackson have that experience, it only helps us. And it was great for him to go out there. They got the win against Korea. You know, it's a fantastic experience for him, and it just grows the love of the game inside those boys when they get those opportunities.
So you mentioned there about line combinations, your fourth line. Tonight you had the line of Sam Smith, Alan Armour, and Tamas Elias on that line. They were just firing on all cylinders.
They were fantastic, absolutely fantastic. I mean, you know, we looked at it and we thought that by putting Tamas on that line with Sam, that he'd win a lot of puck, especially down low. You've got Arms, he's got a great brain, he can pick a pass, and Sam can skate all night. And those two guys basically looking out for those passes, looking out for Sam. And then Tamas's tenacity to just drive the net, and you know, he's got a couple of goals tonight playing on that line. But he gets goals on every line we put him on. You know, he's been a fantastic asset to us. And it was nice to mix the lines up tonight and see how it would work going forward. We got Tim Burrows to come back into the fold as well. I mean, Tim took warm up tonight and then jumped off the ice. He's not feel ready to play, but I think he's a week or two away from actually stepping right back into it. And it gives us problems because we've got a few healthy scratches tonight, not on the roster. But it's nice to have that.
So with Tim Burrows coming back into lineup now, surely that's more or less a good thing. So you've got quite a dominant team anyway. You've got one of the highest scoring offenses, and also you're giving up the fewest goals against in the league. Yeah. So with Tim coming into that fold, does that just make you even more threatening down the stretch?
Hugely. I mean, Tim is he's an EPL player. because of his job, he can't play at that level anymore. He's focusing on his career, and you know, I've had Tim since he was 18 years old with me here before he moved on to play Elite League and then EPL. So his skill set is phenomenal. I mean, him and Sam Smith, you know, I think it's quite obvious to everyone they're not in this league. They're not in the league above. They're EPL players at least, and to have him here with us is fantastic. It just helps us over the line.